time on my channel here with you all doing any kind of wet material, like painting, watercolor, that type of thing. I know that I mostly focus on graphite drawing and tips on how to draw, but this is a really important tip that I use a lot in my studio with my students, and I want to make sure that you guys have this at your fingertips too. So what I'm going to show you next is how to dry wet paper. So if you're using watercolor, and a lot of times people will have a problem with their paper getting all rigidy, like I don't know if you can see how wiggly this is. So I'm going to show you a couple of tips for how to make sure that your paper dries flat. And I'm going to show you how I think most people do it, which is using tape, which I don't like. So let's take a look down here. So the reason that I don't like tape is that even with this is special artist tape that I buy that is, if I can unpeel it, that is acid free. So it's not going to put any acidy residue on my paper. The problem that I have is that, you know, most artists, what they're going to do is they're going to tape this entire watercolor down to their drawing board so that it's going to then dry evenly, because the tension with the tape all along the edges is going to put equal pressure on the outside edges. And so that tension in the drying will create an even surface here. The reason that I don't like that is that even though this is artist tape specifically formulated for artwork, it's too sticky. I live in Texas where it's really hot, so in the summers, it seems like it gets even stickier. So if I were to leave this on here for 2 or 3 days, what would happen as I peel it off is that it's probably going to tear this paper. One of the things that I do, and I don't know if you can see this, I tend to stick it onto my clothing before I tape it on, because then it's gonna get a bunch of red fuzz from my sweater, and that's gonna make it a little bit less sticky. But even then, I have a challenge with it sticking to my paper. So instead of using the tape, what I'm gonna do is paint a little bit. And then at every juncture that I want to dry, or if I need to stop painting at some point and go do something else, or if I have a layer that needs to then dry, what I'm going to do is use my wax paper. So it doesn't matter what brand you have. It's not going to work with parchment paper or aluminum foil. Don't try those. But wax paper, what it does is it has a wax coating that keeps it waterproof. And I'm actually gonna tear out 3 so that I can show you how to layer multiples if you have multiple pieces going on. So what I'm going to do is then enclose my drawing or my painting, and you want to make sure that this part isn't totally wet. So, you know, if you can see a glare on it, that means it's too wet. If you touch it and some of the paint comes off on your finger, that means it's too wet. So it needs to air dry for a minute or two. And then what I'm going to do is enclose it with wax paper on the bottom, then the painting, then wax paper on the top. And then I'm going to take a stack of books here and place larger books than the painting over top. And then usually what I do is I let that dry for anywhere from 8 to 24 hours, depending on the season. If it's really hot, I can usually just leave it overnight. If it's a colder, more damp day, then I'll leave it for a little bit longer. And then what I do is I work with a student, we work on a painting. I put the stacks of books on maybe 10 minutes after they leave the studio, and then I leave it overnight until the next day. And then when I come into the studio in the morning, I take the books off, and then I let the paper, it will still be slightly damp because it hasn't had any air circulating around it. I'll let it air dry for maybe 2 hours. And then I'm going to put it back into the paper and let it dry for another overnight period. And that is going to be my process. So dry for about 8 to 12 hours, let it out for about 2 hours, dry for the rest of the day and then overnight. And so that usually is enough to make this process work for me. Now, this depends on your climate. So like I said, if you live someplace that's tropical and humid, you're gonna have a little bit of a different process. You might need to let it out for 2 hours and dry it for 3 or 4 nights because your environment is such that it's going to make the paper absorb more moisture from the air. The other thing you can do is that if you have worked on a painting and it has gotten all wrinkly, now this is still good watercolor paper, so it's a better paper that is built to absorb the water and the moisture of the paint. So this one isn't super wrinkly, but what you can do is get a larger brush. So here it's a 1.5 inch brush. Dip it into water, turn your painting over, and just evenly coat water on the back side. You'll need to reload your brush occasionally. You don't want it to be super wet, but just wet enough that the whole page is going to get just a little bit more damp. And now what this is doing is it's reabsorbing some water into this paper, but it's not messing with the painting that I did. So I'm not actually impacting the painting at all. Instead, I'm just making the water absorb into the backside. Now you can see there's a little bit of glare on there, so I need to wait until it's not shiny. And then I'm going to sandwich it again. And you can even do this with multiple pieces. Now, I would put this one below because it's a larger piece of paper. And I want to get that centered. Still gonna wait for this to dry just a little bit. And you can see that it's actually buckling in a different way now that I've made it wet. So you can see this U shape is kind of coming out. Let's let that dry for a second. Okay, so there's piece one. Then I'm going to put my second piece of wax paper on. Then if I want to stack a second piece that's drying as well, you can do that. I don't usually do more than 2 or 3 of these at a time. Then I put a third piece of wax paper on there. And then I'm going to center my book so that it's covering up the entire piece of paper, which this one, it just barely doesn't. So then I would let that sit for overnight, at least 12 hours, and then pull it off in the morning, separate the two pieces of paper out. So you're gonna pull the wax paper, set that aside, set this on the table, set the wax paper aside, set this on the table separately, and then let those air dry with air circulating around them for about 2 hours, and then stack it again overnight. So that should flatten out this piece of paper so that it's not gonna be all ridged. It won't work if you're using something like computer paper, printer paper, notebook paper, school paper, anything like that, that is a little bit more fragile and not meant to absorb water at all. So it's not gonna work for your non-water media paper, but if you're using good watercolor paper or printmaking paper, this is a great method to use. So I hope that helps you guys out, and let me know if you have any questions below.